Imagine this, the year is 1987. You just finished putting the last of your three kids through college, and now you're looking to head out on the open road and explore America. You might find yourself looking for one of these, a 1987 Toyota Granville with a four-cylinder Toyota engine. We are in Maryland. It's cold, it's snowing, I'm freezing my ass off, and I want to take my wife away, and I brought home this fucking thing. It's a 1987 Toyota Granville, four-cylinder engine, RV, and my wife is just crazy enough to be like, all right, honey, make it happen. Try to be best, cause you're only a man, and a man's got to learn to take it. Try to believe, though the going gets rough, that you got a hand tough to make it. History repeats itself, try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one. Built on a Toyota pickup chassis, you would look for the reliability of the Toyota truck, ease of parking, a nice manageable vehicle to drive if you don't have any experience driving larger trucks, and you'd have plenty of room in there for you and your wife to enjoy your golden years. So this is going to be the business side of your RV. It's away from the door. If you were to have an awning, the awning would be on the other side near the door. Here you're going to have your sewage holding tank, your wastewater holding tank, your fuel for driving the rig, connection for your electric, connection for your city water. So this is going to be the business side. Around the other side is going to be your pleasure and recreation side. This is the rear end of the Granville. Has a nice bumper that I'm told not to attach anything for towing on the back of because it won't support it. A ladder so I can access my roof if I need to reseal the roof or check on my air conditioner. So this is going to be your pleasure side. If you were to have a awning, your awning would be installed up here. You have access to your liquid propane gas, different storage, batteries, a nice step to let you into your coach. Screen door. Can access the handle to it from the inside. Come on guys, I'll show you the interior. Welcome to the master suite for you and your camping partner. If you want to get cozy, keep each other warm, that's the best way to save on your heating and cooling costs, or at least your heating costs. Part of the bed is removable, so you have more room when you're driving. It makes you feel a little bit more open and spacious. Let's see if I can get my full 6-foot frame laid out.
Yep.
The dismount. You want to see my restroom? All right, one of the problems with buying a vehicle from 1987 is it comes equipped with all the sensibilities of a 1987 vehicle. So we have the dark wood interior paneling, the nice pea green carpet, some of these things that you might want to bring into the new millennium if you were to do some new interior design and decoration. Here we have the galley kitchen, the refrigerator, cooking range and stove. Sink, storage under the sink, some drawers, some storage above the sink. Quite a bit of storage space here. They have the optional exhaust fan for venting your stove. We have the dinette. Theoretically, it seats three. Take it and my poles out. There's some over here if I want to make a little bit more leg room. And my bed does come down, or my, there we go. There's the magic trick. This is the control panel for your pump. Liquid propane gas, battery, holding tank, gray water tank, fresh water tank, and then your thermostat. Hello out there! Here is my air conditioning unit control. Has a fan only setting, low cool, high cool, and off. Welcome to the cab portion of the RV. If you've ever been inside an old Toyota pickup truck, you'll feel right at home inside this RV. No airbags to be found. It's an automatic with overdrive, and my Toyota Motorhome Club friends tell me never activate the overdrive, because overdrive was not supposed to be used when you're carrying a load or when you're under load. And if you're driving around with an RV, you're always under load. So overdrive off at all times. Very basic features. We've got our heating system and cooling system, air conditioning, recirculating versus fresh, ashtray, cigarette lighter, overdrive indicator, which mine will always be on the off position. The radio.
This is our
Pioneer. Emergency brake. Automatic transmission. Hazard lights. Directly above me is the bed, which if I want to feel like I have a little bit more headroom, I can just take this portion off and then let in a lot more light and give myself the illusion of more space. Here's the old cigarette smoker's window. Back then you used to smoke with your kids in the car. Just put this vent on, hold your cigarette over here. The legendary Toyota 22RE. EFI, electronic fuel injection.